Hello students, welcome to class. Today I'm going to talk about a lesson called the Sermon at Benares from your first flight book. In the title, the word sermon means a lecture, you know, given by a learned person, and it can be a form of an advice based on old theological scriptures. And these sermons later turn out to be life's teachings. It becomes a law or belief. In simple words, you can say it's a kind of advice from a learned person about life. The Sermon at Benares is related to the life of Gautama Buddha. Now, we all know the story of Lord Gautama Buddha. Gautama Buddha was born to a North Indian royal family, and as a prince, he was kept away from all the sufferings happening around him, because all the royals are kept like that. When he was 12 years old, Siddhartha Gautama, that was his original name, he was sent to a school where to learn the Hindu sacred scriptures, holy scriptures. And after 4 years, when he returned, he got married. And one day, when Gautama Buddha or Siddhartha went hunting, he saw some unpleasant sights, and it was his first experience about the world, about life, that really changed his whole life and thought process. He first of all saw a sick man, then an aged man, a funeral procession, and a monk begging for alms. These four scenes, or you can say sights, had really made a deep impact in his life. And from these, he took a different turn. He left his royal palace and he went in the hope to search the true meaning of life. And then he came upon attaining salvation. He gave his first sermon in the city of Benares, and this is what the first sermon about that we are going to talk about. He gave this to a lady named Kisa Gautami. He gave her an advice or sermon, the first one. And Kisa Gautami had a son who died, but Kisa Gautami was not able to accept the death of her son so early, and she suffered an unending pain. She went from house to house, looking for a medicine to bring her son back to life. But people, who noticed her, they start thinking that this lady had lost her senses. Then one day, as she roamed around, she met a man, and this man directed her towards Lord Gautama Buddha, who could possibly, give her a solution. And when she approached Buddha, Lord Buddha asked her to look for mustard seeds from a house that had seen no death, in their family. So with a great, hope that she became hopeless for some time now, with a great hope, she went again house to house asking for, some mustard seeds. But then each and every family denied that they, to give her, because they had someone whom they lost in their family. And very disheartened, Kisa Gautami, then sat at the edge of the road, and then she, at the time, some realization dawned on her, and she started thinking that how selfish she was. She realized that she was holding on to something that is absolutely impractical and abnormal, and this is what Gautama Buddha wanted her to know. And Kisa Gautami, then she realized that life and death is a process, and suffering and sorrow is a part of life, and if we start fighting against them, we'll be suffering more, we'll be more unhappy. So Gautama Buddha, indirectly, in a very beautiful way, gave a wonderful lesson of life to Kisa Gautami. So you can read on with the lesson to know more. I'm sharing another video with you regarding this story. Thank you.
On a time, there is an old tale from Buddhist era. The tale about Kisa Gotami. Kisa Gotami is a mother with her only baby. As her only child, Kisa Gotami very, very loved him. But her happiness won't last long. Her only son passed away because of untreated disease. Kisa Gotami very sad as she were orphan and she never felt the loss before. She ran away to the town, seeking a help to revive her only child. Help my baby. Everybody thinks he was crazy, but come a wise man that recommended her to seek Buddha under the pipala tree. And then Kisa ran to meet the Buddha. Buddha means the enlightened one, which Kisa Gotami hoped that the Buddha can revive her child. As Kisa meets the Buddha, she was amazed by Buddha's shining aura. Buddha can revive her child. And the Buddha gave her one condition, a mustard seed. But it must from the still complete family. Kisa asked the villagers one by one whether he or she still had complete family. But Kisa cannot find someone that never lost their family member. In the end, Kisa learned that there are no still complete family because death was part of life. After she realized, she accepted the truth. And Buddha told her to breathe her child.
Finally, realization dawned on Kisa Gotami and she realized the meaning of life and death, suffering and grief, how important they are in a part of life. We cannot do away with them.